Hello, this is Amarjot Singh. I'm a CCRC consultant based in Edmonton, Canada, and today is April 16th, and I'm about to talk to you about the recent changes announced today, actually, as you see on the screen. Government of Canada brings medical inadmissibility policy in line with inclusivity for persons with disabilities. If you don't know what medical inadmissibility is, let me show you on the screen so that you know what kind of pain some people were experiencing earlier, especially in economic class applications. Let us suppose that you were an express entry applicant with a lot of points, let's say 450, 460 points, and with a family member of, let's say, husband, wife, and two children, and one of the child had autism or a mentally, has some kind of handicap or some intellectual disability or a hearing impairment or some kind of problem or some kind of development delay problem that would have killed your application. That means you would not be eligible for the economic class express entry, even though you had high points till now. And I don't know when this policy is being put into force, but for now the announcement was made today, so it will come soon. Let's take a look at what is the law so far. This is called excessive. It's right here on, if you can see on the screen right here. This is called excessive demand on health and social services. Let's take a look at right on the screen. So individual is likely to place excessive demand on health social services if the demand is excessive on our provincial health and social services. The immigration will automatically make this application inadmissible. That means no visa for the family. All right. I will take a look at the definition of excessive demand. So demand on health and social service for which the cost would likely exceed average Canadian per capita health services and social services cost over the period of 5 consecutive years. All right, so this is what the thing is. So just to be simple so that you understand how this the cost would play a factor, take a look at this. There's a cost factor. I'll show you the amount, which is should be listed somewhere here. Here it is. Effective January 1st, 2017, the updated cost threshold is this. In plain words, if the cost of the services required for that child who had a mental disability exceeded 6655 per year, that means application is medically inadmissible. That's what it is. All right, so there are a lot of instructions that used to be followed in how to do this, but I don't want to go there right now because I think this all will go away to a great extent. Look at all this things: autism, deafness, legal blindness, intellectual disability, significant behavior, psychiatric, and all those things. So there could be many examples. I remember a case. This was a landmark case about a few years ago. There was a professor, American professor, with a very good job somewhere in Vancouver, and he was very high in the economic class criteria at the time on the point system. But his son had some, I think, autism, and the application was denied right away. And there was no appeal, nothing, no humanitarian compassionate, no temporary resident permit, no leave at all, no special minister's permit. All those applications will likely go away now. So this is what is the announcement today. Let us go to exactly what the words are in the news release. As you can see on the screen, this is on April 16th, which is today. The immigration minister has announced these changes today. Take a look at what is going to happen here. This is the highlight of the changes. Let me just highlight this. So increasing the cost threshold to 3 times. So remember what I was showing you here was 6655. Where's that thing? 6655. So this will likely go to multiply by 3. What is that? About 18, about $19,000. So what the government is expecting is, what the government is thinking is, because most of the cost per year for the child, if the economic class applicant comes here, they have sufficient funds that if they are willing to, or if they are capable of taking the cost of, you know, that social services, the health services, and if it's likely less than $19,000, so the child is no longer medically inadmissible. So that's what they're trying to do, and this will benefit a lot of people. So this is a change by government as of today. And also look at here, amending the definition of social services by removing references to special education. So somebody requires special education, those will likely not be part of the social services. Somebody requires rehabilitation services, social or vocational and personal support services, those will be removed from the cost threshold formula itself. So I think this will benefit a lot of people, but not all, but a lot of people for sure. So this was announced today. Let me see what else. I think I wanted to show you close to about approximately 1,000 cases receive a medical inadmissibility finding. This is 0.2% of applicants who undergo medical screening. So this is, according to government, this is very low, so it's not going to affect, because a lot of Canadians might want to say, look, what happens if they, beyond the cost threshold, if they will access the provincial health services budget, you know, that's an unnecessary drain on the budget of the province for health and social services. So that might be a thing. But hey, the government is saying this is hardly nothing. This is only 0.2% of applicants who undergo medical screening. Down below, in 2015, the savings to provinces and territories due to these policies represented only 0.1% of all publicly funded health spending in Canada. So it's not likely to cause a little stir, more than a little ripple in the whole budget. So only 1,000. But some people who are qualified otherwise, and I think they will greatly benefit by this change. So three times here and amending the definition of social services. So I hope you can let other people know, and this is a good change for future. We don't know when this will come under implementation, but this is announced just today, but so hopefully very soon. If you have any comment or if you have any question about this, so you can type the question in the comment box, and I'll take a look and I'll try to respond. And otherwise, be sure to subscribe to my channel, and I'll post more updates on this. Thank you very much for your time.